This episode was supported by Brilliant.org. Hey, crazies, we have a slight problem. The world we live in, the one filled with things like people, animals, and cars, is described by something called classical physics. It says the world is predictable, but the tiny world of quantum particles is inherently random. Quantum physics says the world is unpredictable, which leads to one question. How can a world made of unpredictable things be predictable? Prepare to have your minds blown. Before we get into particles, though, let's start with something random but familiar, like a penny. Most people consider coins to be pretty random. The reason I like them is because they only have two states, heads or tails. Nice and simple. If you give it a good flip, you're not gonna have any idea what state it's in. When I just flipped it, I got tails, but I could have just as easily gotten heads. Let's say I do it 10 times. I could end up with any number of either state. Totally unpredictable, right? Well, maybe not. While I could have gotten, say, 10 heads, that's not very likely. There's only a 1 in 1,024 chance that will happen. The same goes for the possibility of all tails, a 1 in 1,024 chance. Or another way to say that, there's a little less than a 0.1% chance. That's what we call a probability. And that probability is much higher for mixed states, which is exactly what we ended up with for 10 flips. Even though each coin flip is unpredictable, we can make some predictions about a group of flips. Get a friend, because this is going to take a while. Flip your pennies a lot more than 10 times, say 1,000 times. The more flips you do, the closer the group will tend toward 50-50. For 1,000 flips, that's about 500 heads and about 500 tails, which is an extremely predictable result, and probably, see what I did there? Probably not that surprising to most of you. If you were to flip the coin 1,000 times again, it would probably happen again. In fact, there's only a 1 in 10.7 Google chance you'll get all heads or all tails. So that's probably never going to happen. These are things we develop instincts about. It's predictable. No one ever expects to get 1,000 heads in a row.
Except pennies aren't actually random.
You're right. He's right. Real pennies are not random. They're just very complex. They're only unpredictable because there's a lot of variables to consider. In fact, when my wife and I flipped our coin, we didn't even get 50-50. There was a slight bias toward tails.
Science experiments at home are the bomb, yo!
Waka waka waka, waka waka waka.
But here's the thing. I'm not really talking about pennies. Pennies are just an analogy for quantum particles. Coins have two sides, two states. If that coin is perfectly balanced and perfectly random, well, then it behaves exactly like a photon. Photons have no rest mass, no electric charge, and no color charge. Just a couple of spin orientations and that's it. They can spin forward, what we call counterclockwise or right-handed spin, or they can spin backward, what we call clockwise or left-handed spin. Those are the only options available.
So does that mean circular polarized light is more fundamental than linear polarized light?
Yep, that's exactly what this means. The two linear orientations are quantum superpositions of left and right-handed spin. But spin is the fundamental property of the photon. If you've got a light source like a light bulb, then there's no built-in preference. You have a 50-50 chance of getting either spin state with each photon, just like our perfect penny. Although, unlike the real penny, our quantum penny, photon, isn't really in either state until we actually measure it. It's in one of those quantum superpositions, with a 50% chance of collapsing into either possibility when measured. That's what true randomness looks like. In the penny experiment, we got to look each time to see which state the penny was in. We can't actually see the spin of a photon, so we have to send it through a circular polarizer, like these. If you have a right circular polarizer, it will pass all right circular photons. And it will block all left circular photons. It's either passed or it's blocked. No in between. Each measurement is individually random. But if you do it a bunch of times, like say once for every one of the 10 million trillion photons coming out of this bulb every second, half of them will pass through and the other half will be blocked. Each photon is random, but the whole group isn't. And this works for other photon interactions too. We don't know if any one photon will reflect off of a mirror or get absorbed.
But we do know about 84% of them will reflect, and about 16% will get absorbed. It's not even limited to just photons. It works for any quantum particles. We call this the law of large numbers. If you perform an experiment an enormously large number of times, the results will equal the expectation. That's exactly what happens with the universe. Everything in it is made of an unimaginable number of quantum particles. The Earth, about 10 to the 52 particles. The human body, about 10 to the 29 particles. A single piece of dust, about 1 million 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 particles. A virus, about 100 million particles. I think I've made my point. No matter how random an individual particle is, the thing they're made of will be predictable because of the sheer number of particles. No, 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 no! Whew, that was close. As usual, if you have any questions, please ask in the comments. Honestly, there was so much I wanted to talk about in this video, I really had to rein myself in. Thanks for liking and sharing this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to keep up with us. And until next time, remember, it's okay to be a little crazy. Still feeling like you need some practice with probability? Then check out Brilliant.org. Brilliant is a problem-solving website designed to train you to think like a scientist on a wide variety of topics. They even have a thorough course on probability that could really hone your skills. There are questions about coin flips, dice rolls, and playing cards, all of which are great analogies for quantum systems. If you find yourself struggling, that's okay. Making mistakes is often the best way to learn. Brilliant even has hints and solutions to get you into that critical frame of mind. It's a great way to practice without too much pressure. Brilliant was nice enough to sponsor this video and crazy enough to offer you a discount. The first 72 people to visit brilliant.org/scienceasylum will get 20% off an annual premium subscription. It's a really good offer if you're interested in getting some extra practice. The featured comment comes from Neurotransmissions, who asked, "How can the universe have no edge?" Well, there are two possibilities. One, the universe is infinite, so of course it doesn't have an edge. Two, the universe is finite, which is a little weirder. If you travel far enough, you end up back where you started. Anyway, thanks for watching.